Hi guys, I'm so sorry I've been MIA for so long, but I am back and I will be recording many more videos for you guys, but here I'm just showing you what I wore for my holiday party at work, and you guys can use it for your holidays, any parties or Christmas. I first started out with the NARS primer and just put that all over my lid, and then I'm going in with the MAC paint pot in soft ochre as usual. I definitely tried in this video to use different eyeshadows because I know I always use the same one, so I'm trying to give you guys more variety. So I finally got the Tarte lip palette, and I'm using that kind of matte medium brown. It's a lot really similar to soft brown, so if you have that, this is basically an alternative to soft brown. It looks just like it. I just wanted to use something different for once. And then I'm going in with this Makeup Geek color, and you guys can see I dinged it. I was so sad. But this is in the color Bitten. It's just a matte kind of burgundy maroon purple shade. And I'm just putting that in the outer corner and a little bit under the lid, just kind of like smoking it out a little bit and just blending that into the crease about halfway. After placing that same maroon Bitten shadow on the lower lash line, I'm going to be going in with this black. It's a matte black. It's from the same Tarte palette. And I'm just putting that over the burgundy, kind of smoking it out. Don't apply too much. I just kind of tap it and then put it on the lid. Just tap it on the lid and then get rid of any excess and then just blend it out. You don't want it super, super dark. You really want that burgundy shade to still show, so this is just kind of deepening it. And then I'm gonna be going I don't know what I'm doing there but I'm going in with this MAC pressed pigment in Summer Honey, and I'm just using my finger to place that all over the lid. I feel like it looks more sparkly and shimmery with the finger, but it's not too chunky. When I usually apply it with a brush, it comes out too chunky and it kind of gets a lot of fallout, but with the finger it kind of still gives you that shimmeriness but not overly chunky, I guess. How many times can I say chunky? And then I'm also putting it in the inner corner and a little bit on that lower lash line in the front and the inner corner as well. So just do that. And as usual, I am going in with my Inglot gel liner. I prefer like a waterproof or a really water resistant eyeliner if you're going to be using one, just in case. I don't know, I prefer my eyeliners not to budge, but any gel liner, any liquid liner, I prefer matte. Also, this one's matte as well, so kind of, I feel like any like glossy one would counteract with the glitter on the lid. And now I'm just going in with my Too Faced waterproof eyeliner. I forgot the exact name, but as usual, I have everything listed down below. And this is in, I think, Perfect Black. It's a really, really creamy eyeliner, waterproof. I really doubt it's really waterproof on the waterline, but still. I'm just putting that on the waterline to deepen the look. And then I'm going in with my my Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Foundation in number 40, and then the Perricone MD No Bronzer Bronzer just to deepen it, because it is a little light for my skin, and I really just wanted to use this foundation for that nice matte finish. I just prefer matte, and I've been loving this foundation lately. I'm like pretty much out, but I'm just like waiting to buy it. I really want to finish the foundation before I buy a new one, because I always buy new ones and then I never use them, so I want to make sure I actually use it all. And then I went over it with my, I set the foundation with my Laura Mercier loose powder as usual, and then I'm going in with my Dolce & Gabbana tan blush. It's not really a blush, but it's in the color tan. It's just a beigey brown, like a grayish beigey brown, and I'm just using that to contour. Now I'm just going in with my Bobbi Brown matte bronzer. I think this is in the color Natural. And I'm using my Marc Jacobs bronzer brush and just putting that on the forehead and the neck just to kind of blend everything in so I don't look too pale and just kind of give me the little tan look. Also, I am going in with MAC's Gingerly Blush. I've also been obsessed with this blush. I don't know why. I completely forgot I had it, never used it, and then now I'm like wearing it every single day. And now I'm going in with MAC's lip liner in Vino and just lining my lips so the lipstick, I don't know, something about lining your lips, it makes you just fill them in so much easier. I was just fixing my nose ring. Then I'm going in with, Lime Crimes Velveteen in Wicked. And there's nothing like a red lip for the holidays. And I just prefer deeper reds because I don't like lighter reds. And then I completely forgot to fill in my brows, so I'm going in with the Tarte Brow Powder in Medium. And that's pretty much it for the finished look. I really, really hope you guys liked it. I will be making many more videos. I will have a haul video up very soon. I'm just waiting for it to get everything in the mail. The rest of it should be here tomorrow or the rest of this week. So yeah, I will have many more videos up for you guys. I really hope you guys like this look. I definitely tried to use some new products because I feel like I use a lot of the same ones almost every day. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye!